Super Bowl, I must say, was an awesome experience. It came with all sides to it. There was the beautiful part, there was the really challenging part.
Getting hot and hot, and that's just because this is Super Bowl.
Super Bowl that night was beyond, you know, what I thought it would be. Not in terms of the competition now, in terms of the organization.
Preparing for Super Bowl was not such an easy task. We had to prepare through schoolwork and all of that. But the most challenging part was the time allocated to the speech. We're given 3 minutes to make a world standard speech, but I felt 3 minutes was just too fleeting. 3 minutes was too short a time for you to make mad sense. So I advocated for an additional 2 minutes, but my proposition degenerated into an argument.
I had been a part of many other competitions, many other public speaking activities, but I knew this one was different. I knew I had to put in all I'd got to make it to the end if I really wanted to. Because I saw bright people, I saw great people who I was meant to be contesting with. I knew it was going to take a lot from me.
He was just the clown he is, you know. He really kept people on their seats. The program started late, but I don't think a lot of people felt it that much because he just kept everybody laughing. I like him very much. He's this very natural person. Natural, very fun, interesting to be with, you know. Just kept the whole day very lively. Kudos to you, man. Mr. BC Crown. Wow, that man is what I call motivation. He's awesome. My experience with him was mind-blowing. He just could spur you up from doing nothing to doing the whole world. That man is great. God, I can't imagine what he has done to my life, and I can't imagine what he would have also put into so many more of us.
I was following the events, and after the main speech, I thought to myself, well, clearly you're in the lead. When we went for the excerpt, I did my best. Mandela looked like him, talked like him, and everything. Of course, I was expecting to come out tops. But when I heard, okay, started as best female speaker, DJ Soma, best male speaker, Yemi Sony. Best impromptu speaker, DJ Soma, best excerpt, Yemi Sony. Well, I knew it was between me and DJ. Now, but when I heard best main speech, believe me, and I still think that maybe it should have gone to me. Well, that part of the whole equation, I seem not to agree with. But yes, the judges knew what they were looking for.
The crop of judges we had that day was a fine set of judges. Judges who know their onions. Judges that I call world standard judges. You know, judges that can prove their mettle anytime, any day. So I believe their judgment that day was devoid of sentiments, bias, and they did their job to the best of their abilities.
Wow. The executive treatment, you'd mean the limousine and all the paparazzi that came with Super Bowl. It was beautiful. It helped me to see that really there was a star in me and that much more was yet to come.
Dinner was the first of its kind. It was interesting. It was beautiful. After a long day, you stressed yourself, you know, backstage, the agitation and everything. It was a time for you to cool off. It was beautiful, the awards and all of that.
A simple tune that you can hum along to. I remember there was a time when I used to sing for you. Do, 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 do.
The moment in Super Bowl that really blew my mind, I don't think I would ever forget the few minutes before the winner was pronounced. I was tense. I couldn't believe that it was going to be me, you know, and then it came. I was happy. I would never forget it. I told myself I was going to tell my children, my grandchildren, everybody that cares to hear. I was happy. It was like dreams come true. I dreamt it. I was at the first Super Bowl when Chioma was named winner. And I told myself I could do it too. And look at it, I actually did it. I was happy, very happy. I felt fulfilled, my mind was blown.
Beyond the competition, I see Super Bowl as a stepping stone, as a place to prepare for the big stages out there, the platforms.
Even if your hands are shaking and your faith is broken, even as the eyes are closing, do it with a heart wide open. My heart. Say what you need to say. Say what you need to say. Say what you need to say.